हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम कांति सर एंड वेलकम्स यू इन अवर मैथमेटिक्स ऑनलाइन क्लास. नाउ यू कैन सी इट इज़ अवर लेक्चर नंबर 10 एंड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड हियर प्रॉपर्टीज एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ ऑपरेशन मल्टीप्लीकेशन. ओके, इन टू डेज वी गोइंग टू प्लान to start division process. Actually, you have been using division since so many years, but here systematically what is property and particularly for rational numbers. So far whatever you've done for integers. Okay, so let's see. First of all, just like addition, subtraction and multiplication, here also basic properties of this operation. So open your book first of all at page number 19. So here is how to divide rational numbers. So if AB is divided by C by D, suppose you want to divide this rational number by this one, then understand here A by B multiply D by C. Why? Because it is divided by. So just like in exponent lesson, we used or we converted division sign into multiplication sign. Here also same way, same thing also. So just convert division sign into multiply by inversing, reciprocating the second number, means divisor. This is called divisor. So divisor should be reciprocated, inversed. Understood? So again, it is the case of multiplication itself. Okay, so you just switch over from division to multiplication. Then nothing is new. Understood? Giving you one example also. Suppose 2 by 3 is divided by 6 by 4. Then what will be that? So 2 by 3 multiply, now reciprocate 6 and this number. So it will be 2 to the 4, 3 to the 6, because in a multiplication we can cancel out anyway, numerator denotator, 2 by 2, 1. Okay, so how this multiplication sign is being converted into, sorry, how division sign is converted into multiplication sign, you understood. Okay, now let's see properties one by one. So first property, when a rational number is divided by another rational number, then the quotient is also rational. So here closure property is there. Okay, so actually in division, closure property is for rational number only. For natural number, for whole number or for integer, no closure property for division. No closure properties followed in division. Only in rational number closure property is there. If you remember, I given you one table like structure in previous lecture. So where closure property followed? In addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, here in which set? So by tick and cross I have given to you. Okay, if you want again, you just watch that video again and take screenshot. Okay, so here closure property is there, means if you divide 2 by 3 by 8 by 6 just like that, somewhat different, then they inverted that next second fraction, then what we got? 1 by 2. So obviously it is rational number, because rational number means right now we are having biggest set. So whatever number is rational number right now, okay, right now, not in next standard. Okay, so in standard 8 we have biggest set is rational number Q. Okay, second one, division of any rational number by itself give the quotient 1. That is very simple. Division of any rational number by 1. Suppose A by 1, A. So A can be 5 by 3. Then answer will be 5 by 3. Can be minus 2 by 7. 10 if divided by 1 minus 2 by 7. So any rational number divided by 1, it will be itself just like multiplication. Property number 3. When a rational number is divided by 1, property number 2 was what? Division of any rational number by itself. Okay. So right now this is property number 3. So first of all, understand this one. By mistake, I explained it first. Okay. Now skip number 2. Comment number 3. If rational number is divided by 1, then quotient will be what? Quotient means answer will be what here? Itself only. Itself. 5 by 3 only. Minus 2 by 7 only. Okay. Now come again for property 2. Now they are telling number is dividing by itself. So suppose a by a. 1. 5 by 3 upon 5 by 3. 1. Because cancel out, everything cancel out in numerator and denominator, obviously it is 1. Okay, so answer is 1. So this is property 2, then property 3. Okay, in multiplication also we studied same properties are there yesterday, means in previous lecture. Okay, property 4, 0 divided by any rational number is always 0. 0 divided by any number, property 4. Zero divided by any rational number will be zero only. This is general form. Suppose I take particular example 5 by 2, then it is also zero. Suppose I take minus 3 by 7, it is again zero. Numerator zero, whatever given in denominator is not important at all. Just see at numerator, answer will be zero. Okay. So I have given few example regarding that. Okay, so all properties so far covered here, no commutative law, no associative law, because commutative law and associative law applies in addition and multiplication only. Commutative law and associative law means what? Telling again and again, commutative law means just place interchange, places interchanged, A plus B, B plus A, A multiply B, B multiply A. So that is commutative law. Associative law means what? Making group. If you want to add or want to multiply three numbers, then you can first of all select any two number. In the answer of that one, you can add or multiply third one. So here commutative or associative law not applicable. Whenever subtraction is there and division is there. So in subtraction and division, no commutative law, no associative. I also told you in previous lecture that one also. Okay, students, now look at example number 16. You might thinking, sir, it is already given in with solution whole example, then why I explaining here? In this sense, solution of any sum is available anywhere. Okay. So don't concentrate only on exercise. Use just your own way, solve all examples. Solution is given, nothing. Interpret that, we know that. Okay. So sum of 3 by 5 and 7 by 15 is divided by their difference. The quotient obtained is, first of all, understand the question. Two numbers are given, their sum is divided by their difference. So first of all, we have to take sum and difference. Okay, otherwise you can write in a one step also that. So let's write, first of all, they given two numbers, so sum is divided by their difference. Okay, 3 by 5 and 7 by 15. Now give one thing, these are two numbers, I am not adding, subtracting, nothing like that. Actually, which one is greater? First understand it. Sorry, 7 by 15 here. So until and unless denominator are not equal, you cannot say which one is greater or smaller. So I can say here, if I multiply by 3, means just like LCM, then it will be 15 and it will be 9. So it will be 9 by 15. So obviously this one is greater. So you just decide first of all, out of both number which one is greater. So for that purpose, you have to make first of all denominator equals. Otherwise you cannot say. And one another way is also there, just convert it into decimal, and this one also in decimal, but I think it is time consuming. Okay, so not advice for that. Just every time make denominator equal, then only you can say this one is greater. Okay, why I am telling about it? Because we are going to take difference also. Difference means always bigger minus smaller. Sequence is not important. Difference means difference. Okay, always positive. Difference is always positive. Subtraction may be negative. Understood? So now they are telling, add them. Subtract them. Okay, that's why I first decided that that one is greater. Now sum is divided by difference. Look at it. Sum is being divided by difference. Okay, so let's simplify this, and there also 15 is LCM here. So write down 3 by 5 plus 7 by 15. Okay, here also 3 by 5. 7 by 15. Now, for getting 15, you just multiply here 3. Same way here also, because totally same, only in between plus and here is minus. But otherwise, first and second number same only. Okay, so how much you got here? It is 9 by 15 and there 7 by 15. So 9 by 15, 7 by 15, divide by 9 by 15 minus 7 by 15. So how much it will be? Now 15 means denominator become common, so 9 plus 7, 16. And here 2 by 15, because after getting denominator equal, you just combine. Combine means either add or subtract numerator. So 9 minus 7, 9 plus 7 right now. But after getting denominator equal, otherwise not. Okay. Now you know how to convert this sign into multiplication sign. So write down here inverse of 2 by 15. So it will be 15 by 2. 15, 15 cancel out. 2 into 8. So it will be 8 only. Okay. So you got here answer 8. Understand well, first of all, it is MCQ, so it will be simple and short. Don't keep this type of belief in your mind. Okay, sometimes MCQ having also long solution. Okay, so first of all, I understood the question well, what they are giving us, because sum of both number is being divided by difference of both numbers. So I taken according to that. Now I know addition or subtraction of fractions. Addition or subtraction of fraction means rational number cannot be done without taking LCM. And I also told before many days, means continuously I am telling you, whenever bigger number is multiple of smaller number, at that time bigger number itself is LCM. So here no need to find or do rough work for finding LCM here, because 15 itself is LCM. So now 15 already is there, here not, so I multiply by 3, so numerator also by 3, same way here. Okay, so this is nothing but a process of taking LCM. Okay, so I got it here on here. Okay, after getting denominator equal, you can add or subtract numerators. Okay, now division sign is converted into multiplication sign by inverting divisor. This is called divisor. Okay, so after cancellation I got 8. Okay, write down or take screenshot right now. Okay, now understand next example. Look there, whatever expression given. So it is quite long, minus 3 by 2 into 4 by 5. I am writing here. It is example number 17. Okay, minus 3 by 2 multiply 4 by 5 plus 9 by 5 divided by 3 by minus 10 minus 1 by 2 multiply 3 by 4. Okay, students, so this is the question only. Okay, and according to Bodmer's rule, you just simplify within bracket whatever given. So simplify whatever given within bracket. So here I can say 2 to the 4. So it will be minus 6 upon 5. Okay. Fraction is negative means numerator is negative. Now I can write here minus 10 by 3 first of all. Then only I will simplify it. Minus. Here nothing is there. So means it is 3 by 8. 3 by 8. Just numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator. If cutting is there, cancellation possible, then you do it first. Then just multiply both ones and both ones here. Okay. No need to take LCM anywhere because in between multiplication division sign. If in between plus minus sign, then only to take it home. Okay. Now let's simplify this one. 3 3s are 9, 5 2s are 10, minus sign is there. So it becomes plus minus 10 minus 3 by 8. Okay, this is answer minus 10. I have kept in bracket because it is negative. Now I can say it is minus 6 by 5 plus minus minus bracket. Whenever you open bracket, it is a multiplication. So it is 10 upon 1. Why writing upon 1? Because if all are fraction, means all are in p by q forms, write down that integer also in p by q forms by placing 1 in denominator. Okay. Okay. Now you know what is the LCM of 8 and 5 and 1. Not consider 1 now. So they are co-prime. So whenever co-prime numbers are there, product is itself LCM. Otherwise, just try to find it. So whenever co-prime numbers are there, product is LCM only. Co-prime means what? No common factor. Here common factor 1 and 5. Here common factor 1, 2, 4, 8. Nothing common except 1. Okay. So co-prime numbers. So multiplication is only LCM. So get everywhere 40. So here minus 6 by 5. Minus 10 by 1. 3 by 8. Understood? I kept here space for getting them multiply. So I want 40. So by 8, by 40, and by 5. Okay, so taking LCM is important here, and I think every now and then you come across this type of process of taking LCM. Okay, now just simplify them. So it will be minus 48 upon 40, minus 400 upon 40, minus 15 upon 40. Just understand that. Sorry, here is 6, 3 to just 6, so not 10,
ओके 3 इंटू टू ओके सो 6 फोर जा 24
ओके नाउ आई राइटिंग हियर दे आर 40 एवरीवेयर बट माइनस 240 एंड माइनस 15 एवरीवेयर ऑल टर्म्स आर हियर नेगेटिव 48 240 15 ओके सो यू नो सेम साइन मीन्स एडिशन So far, you study the 5 plus 3 equal to 8. This is addition. This is subtraction. From first, second standard, you know that. But at that time, you just get first number always positive. But if it is not positive, then what happens? So let's look here. Suppose this is that. Then what will be there? So now addition, subtraction definition is what? If signs are same, it is addition. And if signs are opposite, different, then it is case of subtraction. So if 5 minus 5 plus 3 is there, so you can see your signs different. So take difference and apply bigger number sign there. So bigger number sign is minus, so I apply it. Suppose minus 5 minus 3 is there, then again same sign, just like that. So again add them and again bigger number sign. Okay. So understand. Every time not seeing here only you can decide whether it is addition or subtraction. You have to consider here sign of all ones. Here also you actually consider but here plus, plus minus. Okay. So understand. Whenever do addition and whenever subtraction. When signs of all terms are equal. Then you can add all of them. Whenever sign of first number and second number is opposite, you can subtract them. So take difference and then apply sign of bigger number here. So just add all of them. Why? Because everywhere minus. Okay. So it will be 8 plus 5, 13. 1, 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1, 10. 1 plus 2, 3 plus 1, 4. Okay, so it is, 100 digit is 213, not here. So, minus 303 upon 40. Now, cutting is not possible. You can try. Okay, so minus 303 upon 40 is our answer. Explaining again, first of all, I multiply here, here and here. Cutting is possible because in between is there, so anywhere numerator and denominator, if cancellation possible, you can. So I just cut here, so minus 6 by 5, here also same way, but no cancellation was there, just multiply 3 1s are 3, 4 2s are 8. Now nothing to do, just convert a division sign into multiplication by reciprocating divisor. It is reciprocated, so now I cancel out again, so I got minus 6. Okay. Now this bracket is open, so plus minus minus here. Now, whenever fractions are there and in between plus or minus signs are there, at that time you have to take LCM. Here LCM is 40. Why? Because numbers are coprime, means not common anything. They are not in any numbers table. Okay. So, we got 40 LCM. So, we try to get 40 at all denominators. All denote 5 into 8, 1 into 40, 8 into 5. But at a time, you have to multiply numerator also by same number. So we multiply it. Okay, now you can see here, it is very simple. And why I added all of them? So see, sign of all terms, if everywhere signs are equal, then addition is there. Okay, so I make addition of all of this. Okay, so here division process actually over. It is somewhat like multiplication only. But for getting multiplication sign, you have to reciprocate the divisor. Don't forget that. Okay, now absolute value of rational number means what? Absolute value means what first of all? So absolute value means positive value. Absolute value means positive. So if any two vertical bar you came across any time, you understand sign of minus should be neglected. Okay, if it is there. I giving you a few example. Suppose 3 is there, absolute value of 3, obviously 3, nothing to do. Absolute value of minus 5 equal to 5, understood? So if it is positive, then answer positive. If it is negative, then also answer positive. Means absolute value is always positive, understood? Because some quantities are always positive, never be negative. I say, what is your roll number? Always positive. How many members in your family? Always positive. How many rooms are there in your home? Positive. So we came across mostly numbers, those are positive, never negative. Okay, so for that purpose, sometimes they neglect sign if it is given. Understood? So, this is the case. Okay, look in textbook. They have given one example, absolute value of minus 3 given. So bar minus 3 equal to 3. Absolute value of 3 is also 3 and absolute value 0 is 0 because 0 considered to be positive one. Okay, so only one thing to be kept in mind, and that is to remove negative sign if modulus sign is there. That is called modulus sign, modulus, or value is called absolute value. Okay, this is modulus sign. And if I kept here minus 8, then this absolute value of minus 8 is 8. I can say absolute value of minus 8 is 8. How to read it? Mod minus 8, okay, it equal to 8. Okay, now look properties of absolute value of a rational number. So you can see there, again properties of this operation is given there. So look at first one, we are at page number 20. Page number 20. Okay, what is given in property 1? The absolute value of the sum of two rational number is always less than or equal to the sum of the absolute value of the given numbers. Read it again and again. The absolute value of the sum of two rational numbers. So if you add two rational numbers, suppose A and B is there, and if you add them and take its absolute value, then it is what? Read again there from second statement. Is always less than or equal to. Less than or equal to. But what? Less than equal to what? The sum of the absolute value of the given number. So, sum of the absolute value of given number. So, given numbers absolute value are there. So, A is absolute value, B is absolute. Understood? So, what is the meaning of that? Again, absolute value of sum is less than or equal to sum of absolute value. Understood? So, here absolute value of sum of absolute value. So, it is just like playing with words. We are playing with words like that. Again, absolute value of sum of absolute value. Different. Okay. So, always less than or equal to, but never greater than. Sometime equal to may be there, sometime less than. Okay. So, this is the relation. Now, before going to further any new property, they just giving you few examples for that. Okay, one second property also given. Let's see first of all second property on page number 22. Page number 22. So there is given property number 2. What is there? If AM product, absolute value of the product of two rational number is equal to the product of the, so instead of here less than equal to, there will be equal to, but for product, not for addition. Understood? So it is equal. Either you first multiply and then take product, or otherwise, if you take modulus first of all and then multiply them, both are equal here. Again, if you multiply both of them first and then take its modulus value. Otherwise, you first take their modulus value and then multiply. Both will be same. We will prove it by example also. Okay. So, let's prove first of all that. Suppose A equal to 2 and B equal to minus 5. Then what will be this? A plus minus this one on left hand side is equal to A, open this bracket, the plus minus minus, sorry, A means here 2, here also 2. So 2 plus minus minus 5 is equal to minus 3 equal to 3. Modulus value means whenever you remove modulus sign, it will be positive only. Now look at right side. So modulus of 2 plus modulus of minus 5. So modulus of 2 is 2 only, and modulus of minus 5 will be 5 only, is equal to 7. So you can say it is less than. Okay. Same way you can prove here also. By same number, take same number here. So let's, now this is for addition. Now I retaining this example again. So what will happen? Here is multiplication. Okay, so it will be minus 10, 2 pi is a minus 10 plus minus minus, so it becomes 10. Okay, now 2 modulus 2 multiply modulus 5, so it will be 2 multiply 5, 10, so both becomes equal here. Okay, so it is same case here, but not in addition, in multiplication. Okay students, so we understood both property at a time together. Now look at example number 18. Example number 18. The absolute, sorry, A equal to 2 upon minus 5 and B equal to 3 by 4. Verify that A plus B is less than mod A plus mod B, or mod A cross B means A multiply B is equal to this only, means both we have to verify now. So let's verify first of all. And how to verify any law or property, keep in mind. First you work at left hand side only, then at right hand. Don't compare them priorly, because how you know whether they will be equal or not, because we just verifying it. Okay, so don't assume them to be true. Any property cannot be assumed to be true before verification. Okay, so individually just left hand side is taken and simplified, right hand side taken and simplified. If both values answers equal, then only it is verified, means it is proved to be true. Okay, otherwise not. So don't compare from first way, only left hand side, only right hand side. Okay, they have given A minus 2 by 5. I am writing here that way, because whenever fraction is negative, understand numerator is negative, not denoted. And B 3 by 4. Okay, these are given. Now, in first one, we just say that modulus of A plus B will be less than mod A plus mod B. So mod of A plus B will be less than mod A plus mod B. This is the question only. for verification purpose I taking first of all left hand side, any one side in short. So write down both numbers, minus 2 by 5 plus 3 by 4 is equal to, you can write that way also. So obviously cross multiplication will be there, so 5 or the, okay, whenever co-prime numbers are there and two numbers, only two numbers are there, at that time cross multiplication LCM both becomes same only. So minus 8, now cross way, plus 15 means 7 by 20. So mod 7 by 20 means 7 by 20. If positive, then positive, negative also positive. So it is always positive. Both are placed, cross multiply them, means addition of fractions are there, so take an LCM or multiply cross way, both are same here. So it obtains 7 by 20 here. Now look at right hand side, we are in first one, so it is minus 2 by 5 plus 3 by 4. Now remove modulus sign, so it will be 2 by 5 because mod value is always positive. This is 3 by 4. Again, co-prime number, two numbers are there, so here is 20, 4 to the 8 plus 5 3 the 15, cross way now here. Okay, in denominator only both denominator multiply, but in numerator cross multiply. That's why we say cross multiplication, 23 by 20. Obviously, you can say this one is less than that one, okay. So, therefore, 7 by 20 is less than 23 by 20. So, we can say mod of A plus B will be less than mod A plus mod B, okay. So, first is verify, proved. Okay, write it down or take screenshot again. In second one, it is mod of product and equal to sum of, sorry, product of mod values. So now we have to prove this one. I already given you one example of both ones. Okay, now again, take both values. So left hand side equal to, if you want you can write it again, then only put value, not directly put value, okay. So I just written once. Now minus 2 by 5 into 3 by 4, so 2 to the 4 cancel out, here left minus 1, so it will be minus 3 by 10 means 3 by 10. So this is our value of left hand side. Now right hand side, so first of all only write whatever is there. Now place values, minus 2 by 5 and mod absolute value of 3 by 4. Okay, so now mod signs are removed, so it will be 2 by 5 into 3 by 4, so 2 to the 4, here left 1, so it will be 3 upon 10, both are equal. Okay, so now you can say both are equal, that's why. So therefore 3 by 10 equal to 3 by 10, therefore mod of A cross B is equal to mod A multiply mod B. Okay, so again both properties of modulus are again proved here. I proved once by my own examples. Now they have given to prove them, verify them. Okay, now retaining here for half minute. Okay, now example number 19. Here is MCQ there. So, modulus value of addition will be greater than, equal to, or less than of addition of their modulus value. So, it is regarding property number 1, either less than or equal to, out of 2, any one possibility may be there, because in property number 1, what they say? They say that modulus of addition of any two number will be either less than or equal to of addition of their absolute value. So, either less than or equal to, so maybe 1 will be answer, otherwise B, either A or B will be answer. But let's verify first of all. So, they have given x and y. So, let's find first of all, this is example number 19. Okay. So, what is here? Left hand side is x plus y. So, we have to find, this I have given only example. So, find out x plus y and put values. X is equal to minus 1 by 5, numerator is negative, not denoter. Y equal to 3 by 4. Okay, now place them, minus 1 by 5 plus 3 by 4 equal to, cross multiply, 5 4s are 20, minus 4 plus 15. Plus minus minus 1 4 is 4, 5 3 is 15. So it will be 11 by 20. It means 11 by 20. Positive remains positive. Now right hand side. So what they want to prove? Sum of their modulus value, x plus y. So now x is minus 1 by 5. Plus y is 3 by 4. So write down minus 1 by 5. Sorry, modulus open. Modulus sign open means absolute value is taken. So it will be 1 by 5 only. And this is 3 by 4. Okay. Again, whenever you remove that absolute or modulus sign, negative number becomes positive. Positive number remains positive. Don't convert positive to negative. Positive, positive, negative, positive. Okay, now again 20, 4 1s are 4, 5 3s are 15, 19 by 20. So obviously this one is less. So you can say here modulus value of x plus y will be less than modulus value of x plus modulus value of y. Okay, so option number B is there. B is answer here. Again, in next one, again they want to prove whether equal or less than. Two possibilities are there. So, we have to verify them again if they are equal or not. Okay, students, but it is repeating. So, I don't want to solve same type of sums here again and again, because we already solved example number 18 and 19. So same type of examples are 20 and 21. Property 2 we already explained. Okay. So not giving homework, but you will try to understand yourself. Example number 20 and 21. Now look at assignment 1.1. Many students are asking generally what to write in fair book. Actually, I explained so far twice. Okay, so third time I telling you what you have to write in fair book. Assignment. Assignment 2.1, 2.2, whatever may be. Okay, so all assignments exercise and chapter end exercise. Okay, so many assignment exercise will be there, and chapter end exercise will be one only. It will be one only, but there having many sections are there. So you just write everything, and whenever objective question is there, whenever objective you, and if it is calculative, you write calculation. Don't just tick the answer. Okay, so objective question also be described whenever necessary. Okay, and mostly we exclude higher order thinking skill and value based question. We will do. Okay, but no need to write in fair book. Understood? And up at the end of this lesson, we will do higher order thinking skill and value based question of this lesson also, and of power exponent also, the first and second both together. Okay. Now it is exercise 1.1. MCQs are there. Look at first MCQ. We are at page number 23. Standard form of, now standard form of fraction means what? Numerator is negative. Never denote. Okay. So if sign is here, you just switch over to there. So in first one, answer is minus 28, and cancellation also should be there. So first of all, it will be minus 28 upon 70, but this is not standard form. Standard form is simplest form. After cancellation, whatever left that is. So they are divisible by 7. So 7 into 4 and 7 into 10. Again, 2 by. So this is our standard form. If you want earlier that they are divisible by 14, then directly you can get this answer also. 14 2s are 14 5s are. Okay, so either step by step or directly you can reach by cutting only to standard form and assign sign to numerator, not to denote. Okay, students, so here B is answer and Y you can see here. Okay, this is assignment 1.1 and question number first only. Okay, now look at number 2. Rational number not equivalent to minus 16 upon 28. So look there, minus 16 upon 28. So if you either multiply both of them, otherwise divide both of them by same number, then they will be equivalent. I can say here 32, 56, otherwise 8, 14. If you divide both ones or multiply both ones by same number, then equivalent fractions will be there. Okay. So understand now, 48 and 84. So it is 3s are 16, 3s are 48. And 28, 3s are 84 or not? Just check it. 28, 3s are how much? 8, 3s are 24, 2, 3, 2s are 6, 8. Okay. So it is equivalent. We are selecting not equivalent. Second one, 12, 21. So look there, whether 12 and 21, how they can be obtained. So you can here check separately minus 16 upon 28 and minus 12 upon 21. Okay, so equivalent or not, they can
just cancel out both of them if they are equal or not. So now I can say 4 4 4 7, so it will be minus 4 by 7. I don't know they are equal or what. Simplify this one also. 3 3 4 3 7.
Understood? So this one is simplified, option also simplified, so again they are equivalent. Next, minus 4 by 7, obviously. Next, 64 116, obviously it will be answer, but even you can simplify it.
64 116 116, sorry.
Now you can divide both by, first of all, 4 4, so 16 4s. In here, 4 2s are 8, 3 left, 4 9s are 36. So it is minus 16 upon 29. So obviously this is not equivalent. Understood? So get simplest form, standard form of given number and standard form of all options. Then compare them. Whenever equal, it is they are equivalent. And not equal, not equivalent. So they are asking now not equivalent. So second one is answer. Okay, student. So now we keep it up to that only. Third one in homework. Okay. Now I writing here. And giving you homework from assignment 1.1. So question number first 3, not by taking answer only, you just describe means calculate it. Okay, what should be added to get, to aapko koi numbers suppose karna padega, you have to suppose that number. Okay, same type of example we already solved. Okay, so it is just like a example number 12, example number 12. Okay, you can refer that some. Okay, then 4 also, same type of that, that's right. Number 10. Okay, we solve today only that type of sum there. And if any modulus sum is there, then we can. Okay, no modulus sum is there. Okay, and we solve just like that sum. 11, first and second, like that. So question number 11, first and second. We solve today this type of sum. I telling you where. It is example 17. So they are just like example 17. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Total 5 sums in today's homework. Same type of sum we already solved. Okay. Either today or previously. Understood? So homework given. Okay, so time is over. So students, now we keep our today's lecture up to this point only. Okay, I hope you understood and you do homework sincerely, honestly and with interest only. Thank you.